today we have Ben Rhodes with us.
Nicholas Pagese reporting. CNN, our report on Memphis, also known as the governor.
Advisory that was sent to you. The call is on the record. I will do quick intros and then go to Q&A. So first we'll start with Ben Rhodes.
Great, thanks everybody. I'll say a few opening comments. First of all, logistically, just so you know, we're focused here on the White House meetings on Friday. Obviously, there's a longer program that President Karzai will be engaged in over the course of the week after he and the Afghan delegation arrive here today. That will include meetings at the Department of Defense, State Department, other meetings in town, but we'll focus on Friday's meeting, which will involve a bilateral meeting between the two presidents with their delegations, a working lunch here at the White House, and then a joint press conference with the two presidents. Just to step back and put the visit in context, we are at a place where the president's strategy in Afghanistan is focused on how do we most successfully achieve our core objective while bringing the war to an end by the end of 2014, as the president and his allies and the Afghans have committed to do. The core goal, of course, that the president has set is to disrupt, dismantle, and defeat al-Qaeda and to ensure that they can never return to Afghanistan and use it as a safe haven from which they could launch attacks against the United States or our allies. And that's, of course, been a top priority for our administration. And related to that, we want to have an Afghan partner that is capable of standing on its own with our support, again, in denying safe haven and having the capability to take the lead for its own security and for the future of the Afghan people. And that goal of restoring Afghan sovereignty and denying safe haven to al-Qaeda is one that we share with our NATO and ISAF allies and with the governor of Afghanistan. Last year in Bagram, when President Obama and President Karzai signed strategic framework agreement, President Obama outlined five pillars that are the core of our strategy to responsibly end the war in Afghanistan while achieving that core objective. And those five pillars are transitioning the Afghan lead in the country, training Afghan security forces so they're capable of taking full responsibility for the security of Afghanistan, building an enduring partnership with Afghanistan so that they know they have the support of the United States and NATO beyond 2014, supporting reconciliation within Afghanistan so that there is a place for those who renounce violence and break from al-Qaeda to come back in line with the state of Afghanistan, and promoting regional stability more broadly. And Doug will speak to where we are in those various lines of effort. But this week's visit it comes at a critical moment for the two presidents to take stock on where we are in the transition and then to provide guidance going forward on a host of issues. In 2013, we will be continuing our transition to Afghan security lead. We, of course, have set in Chicago the objective of having a milestone in 2013 where the Afghans are fully in the lead for security responsibility in the country on the way to the Afghans having full responsibility by the end of 2014. So they'll be discussing the 2013 transition. And of course, as it relates to U.S. troops, we completed the full drawdown of our surge in September, bringing us back down to 68,000, the pre-West Point troop levels for the United States.
Nicholas Pagese reporting. CNN, our reporter in Memphis. Nicholas Pagese on conference call with the White House. CNN, our reporter in Memphis. Also known as the governor.
Similarly,
this is a photo of Princess Madeleine given to me from the Royal House this week.
The two leaders will be discussing
CNN, our report on Memphis.
Any potential support for